Welcome fellow Solidworks users to my channel. In this video, I'll show you how to make a mold tool out of a part you have in Solidworks using the Solidworks mold tools box. Now this is a part I had created using basic Solidworks commands like sketch, extrude, revolve, pattern and convert entities. Make sure to check that video out as well. If you want to download the part, I have the link in the description below. Now the first step in the process will be to check if you have mold tools enabled or disabled. If you do not have them enabled, you can right click on features, sketch, surfaces or any of the tabs and enable mold tools. In this video, I'll be going over four basic commands that are parting lines, shut off surfaces, parting surfaces and tooling split. In that particular order from left to right. Let's go ahead and start with parting lines. Click on parting lines. Then it will ask you to select a direction of pull. I'll select the top surface of this part as the direction of pull. Click on the top surface. Then click on draft analysis. Now you can see that the parting line is complete. Mold can be separated into core and cavity. There are these different colors shown on the parts, red, green. These stand for green, positive draft, yellow, no draft, red, negative draft, and blue for straddle surfaces. We do not have any blue or yellow. As you can see, the parting line has already been selected. If not, you can just select individual edges in this dialog box of parting lines. Now that everything is ready to go, I'll just go ahead and click OK to select this parting line. The next feature we'll be using is shutoff surfaces. Shutoff surfaces are useful when you have holes in your parts and the parting line does not complete itself because of such holes. Now in this case, the parting lines appear to be completed. No shutoffs are required, so I'll just go ahead and hit cancel. Then I'll move over to the next feature, that is parting surfaces. In parting surfaces, I'll select the direction as perpendicular to pull. The parting line has already been selected. And for the distance and parting surface, I'll put in 2 inches. This is the distance the parting surface will extend from the parting line. And for smoothing, I'll keep the edges smooth. Go ahead and confirm. Now, there you have your parting surface. The next feature we'll use is Stooling Split. Click on Stooling Split. Then it will ask you to select a plane to sketch on. I'll select the bottom part of the parting surface we just created. I'll change my view to be normal to the sketch plane and then sketch a rectangle that is coincident with the outline of the tray. I'll exit the sketch. And change our view so that we can see the core and cavity surfaces. Now, I'll extrude the core surface to be 0.5 inches and the cavity surface to be at 2.5 inches. Click OK. There we have our tooling split ready and our mold tool is almost complete. I'll go ahead and hide the surface bodies. And now, change our view to exploded so that we can see each individual core, cavity and the original part that we created. This is the core that I just moved aside. Now I'll move the part that we created and there you can see the cavity surfaces as well. Now I'll assign appearance to the core and cavity surface so that we can distinguish it from the part. I'll select solid bodies. I'll select Stooling Split and assign an appearance of cast carbon steel to them so that I can differentiate it from the part we created. Appearance to our original part as well. Thus, we have successfully created a mold tool out of our muffin tray.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to leave a comment, like, share, and subscribe, and follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. I'll see you in the next one.